Hey, everybody, I'm Ashley, and welcome to this month's edition of The Dollar Club, our opportunity to give just $1 and see the amazing things that can happen when we all do good together. This month, hundreds of thousands of students across Middle Tennessee went back to school, and we want to celebrate educators. So today, we're at Jere Baxter Middle School in East Nashville, sitting down with Principal Cox and Ms. Spaulding to talk about the upcoming year. Alicia, this is your first year teaching.
It is.
It's your first week. How's it going?
It's going awesome. I'm excited.
And you started as a substitute teacher, right?
I did, yes, ma'am.
What was it for you that you decided now was the time?
I decided that I wanted to jump in because I realized that students need an advocate and they need a support system. And I wanted to be a part of that.
What subject are you teaching?
English, seventh grade.
And what do you love about it?
Oh, I love how we're exploring a lot of creative writing styles. It's giving them opportunities to learn to be critical thinkers, to know who the who is, the why, the what, the how, identifying the emotions of the narrator. They're enjoying it. I've had a lot of scholars, can I read, can I read, can I read? No, it's my turn. I want to read. So they are ready. This is going to be a great year.
There are over 80,000 students in Metro Nashville Public Schools, which is incredible. 159 schools, 29 middle schools, which you guys are obviously a part of. Can you talk about just your students here?
Jere Baxter is a special place. We have about 400 scholars. We have over 15 different languages spoken within our school. Our scholars are highly intelligent. We approach every interaction with, you are me. We want you to be your best. We want you to feel your best. We want you to think positive. So it's important that we are responsive to their needs and provide them the space to be who they are.
It's just constant affirmations. Thank you. Good job. You've read great today. Even glad to see you. When they get into this atmosphere, they can be reminded that they're valued and cared for.
I know that you also have programs here to support not only your students, but their families as well. You have a hygiene closet. Can you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yes, so we saw a need, whereas a lot of our families were experiencing financial challenges. They just didn't have the basic needs. We started a clothing closet, and we have a washer and dryer here, whereas families can come and wash their clothes at no cost. We provide washing powder, soap, deodorant, feminine products. We've noticed that when scholars don't have the basic needs, they're oftentimes disconnected from the learning process because they're thinking about where my next meal is coming from. Like what 12-year-olds should like have that occupied on their psyche.
Yeah.
Are my lights gonna be on when I get home? Is my mom gonna be home when I get home? Because the reality is a lot of our parents work 2 and 3 jobs and they're still unable to meet those needs. But I have to say here at Jere Baxter, we have teachers who have spidey senses. They're able to identify that need without the scholar even saying anything.
How are you stocking that hygiene closet?
Most of the resources and supplies are purchased from staff members.
For your teachers to be taking that out of their own pockets to supply those closets and the needs of your students, especially a new teacher, can be financially difficult.
I didn't have the funds, the means to set up my first classroom the way that I desired and planned. The school supported me with a lot of school supplies. I even had a teacher to get all my number 2 pencils sharpened for me and had them all nice on my desk. It made me want to really just do the same thing back. I want to be a support during their learning process.
Our teachers make so many sacrifices on a daily basis for our scholars. We're just forever grateful for just the village of just advocates for our scholars.
Well, I know that we said that we wanted to share your story, but at CrossPoint, we also have this thing called the Dollar Club, where once a month, we ask everybody in the church to throw in an extra dollar, pool that money together, find a need in the community that needs to be filled, and go fill it. And I know that being a first-year teacher is hard and exciting and you thrive, but also like can be financially difficult. And so I have a check for you just because of the generosity of a whole lot of people for $10,000.
Are you serious?
I'm sorry.
Like what?
For real?
Oh,
yes, for real. It's just the generosity of a whole lot of people.
Why'd y'all do that? Okay, oh gosh.
No, it's okay.
Thank you so much. Oh, my God.
Are you really?
Are you for real?
Like, can I give this to you?
Can I? Yeah, okay.
Wow.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
That's too much.
Thank you.
That is just a lot.
I am happy.
I am too. I'm happy and cryy and teary and...
I'm going to give this
to you. Okay, thank you so much.
Oh,